Do you have supported and recommended hardware, but your Hackintosh is still not running or not running great? Let's find out what could be the problem. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonau.cloud and I help people to save money on their Hackintosh builds. I help them simply to build the perfect Hackintosh. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. A lot of people search internet for ages to find good working clever folder for their Hackintosh, but still can't find the only one, the best one. So, as you know already, the only best config is the one you create and tweak yourself for your particular Hackintosh build. Or if you get some of the configs created by myself, which I offer to download. But again, it works only for exact component configuration. So, now imagine you have such an amazing config downloaded, but your Hackintosh is still not running as good as I showed you or as you expect. So, how is this possible? Easy question, easy answer. BIOS. The most important and highly overlooked step in the process of building a perfect Hackintosh is to correctly set up your BIOS. If your BIOS is not set up correctly, you can in some cases will not even be able to run a Hackintosh on it at all, even with perfectly matching clever config. So I decided to make this problematic clear forever and for everyone. In this video I will show you how to correctly set up BIOS for your Hackintosh built on top of ASUS motherboard, and the next time I will show you the same but for Gigabyte boards. So let's get straight into it. In this Hackintosh running behind me, I have the ASUS Prime Z370A motherboard, so let's have a look into its BIOS. To access your ASUS motherboard BIOS, press on boot the delete key or F2 key. You will be greeted with this welcome screen. Access the advanced mode clicking in the bottom right corner or with the F7 key. It's a good idea to update your BIOS to the latest one. Not always the latest BIOS version is the best one for you, but in most cases it is. So first step, update your BIOS. Only in case it will not work as you expected, then you can at any time downgrade it again. On top right corner, click on Tool and enter the ASUS Easy Flash utility. Here you have the option to update BIOS from previously downloaded file from ASUS support website or directly via internet. Now just click on Yes and your BIOS will be updated. I already done that. On bottom click on Exit to exit the Flash utility. On top right click on Exit and now click on Load Optimize Defaults. This is very important step, so don't miss it. Now confirm it by OK. I do not overclock my production machines, so overclocking is not what I cover in this video. So let's walk through all settings we need to change or set so your Hackintosh can run perfectly. Navigate to onboard devices. If you have M.2 NVMe drive like me, set its bandwidth configuration to by 4, otherwise it will not run at its maximum speed. I will now walk through all my screens so you can match it easily. I will just emphasize the most important settings. For sure, disable the serial port. Here, make sure the fast boot is disabled. SATA mode should be set to AHCI. And also be sure the CSM is disabled. Now let's move to next tab. here set your XMP profile for your memory, and don't worry if your speed may be different than mine, we have simply different memory types. Here you can set your overclock, but as I said, I do not overclock at all, so I leave it all untouched. Here the default optimized settings are all okay. Intel virtualization leave disabled, but I saw already some machines that needs this setting, so experiment with it. The same with VTD, I have it enabled, but some machines had problems with it. And now the crucial part, graphics configuration. If you have dedicated GPU, like I have the RX 580 in this build, set your primary display to PCIe and make sure to have iGPU multimonitor enabled. But if you have only one display connected to the iGPU onboard graphics and no dedicated GPU, then set the primary display to CPU graphics. In the configuration with matching SM BIOS and dedicated GPU, the multi-monitor option is mandatory for getting encoding acceleration. IO Epic Entries should be enabled. Here we already set the AHCI mode. And nothing special down here. DPM disabled. Thunderbolt configuration is very individual. I will cover Thunderbolt in one of my future videos in detail. Onboard devices we already set earlier. APM leave as is in default. Network stack disabled. In USB configuration, legacy support enabled. Some boards have also the option for XHCI handoff, so set it as enabled too. In monitor tab, there is nothing to change. Fast boot should be disabled. Boot configuration leave as is. CSM disabled. And secure boot should be set to other OS. And that's all, we are at the end. Now just save your BIOS with the F10 key or confirm the option save changes and reset, and you are good to go. So, you can easily match your BIOS settings to mine I showed you in this video, and your Hackintosh should be ready for installation or later tweaking. If you will have some additional questions, feel free to comment down below. And as I told you, next time I will show you the correct BIOS settings for Gigabyte boards. So I hope you found this video useful. If so, please click on the like button below. Watch also my other tutorials. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. You can also join my Hackintosh and Macintosh groups on Facebook, Reddit or my website. Links are now in this video description. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends.